would like to make a sequel to maybe Heyy Babyy if possible.
We spoke about it. You know, Akshay and I spoke about it. Sajid Nadiawala and I also spoke about it. And it's not a bad idea. So I said I was not that foolish to openly copy a Hollywood film which was so popular. Hmm. It was loosely based on Nanna Farishta and Kumara Baap, but more or less the true story of this friend of mine. Ke Aamir Khan ki film mein toh achhi hogi. So that is a very strong achievement for Akshay and I'm so happy for him. Hi guys, I'm Sajid Khan and you are watching me exclusively only on Bollywood Hungama. I log on to Bollywood Hungama every day. Do you?
I love movies as much as I love life, but when I'm gone, I want to be buried in a cinema compound. My tombstone should read, "Here lies the greatest film buff." Well, that's what Sajid Khan has written in one of the columns that he writes for a newspaper. And the news is that his movie Heyy Babyy is completing 10 years on 24th August. And we'll find out about how he feels about the completion of 10 years and much, much more. Pleasure having you back, first of all, on Bollywood Hungama.
Pleasure having you here. Sabse pehle to main aap sabko bata do ke this man Faridun is a very lucky mascot for me. Every time he comes to my house to do an interview, I get very positive feedback. So here's hoping that today's interview also gets us very positive feedback.
No, I hope so, because even we've got a very good response, especially for our last interview on the terrace.
Yes,
people said
yes.
That we found out quite a few things about Sajid that we never knew. All right, so but when you say that here lies the greatest film buff, that's what your tombstone to be reading. So why do you say that? That here lies the greatest film buff.
I don't think I'm the world's greatest film buff. Mm. I would like to think I'm amongst the top 50 or 100 greatest film buffs of all times, because everything that I know about people, life, history, geography, science is through films. Mm. I don't know the real world outside films. Like if you tell me that there is this Fifth Avenue in New York, I've seen it in some movie. If you tell me about Mount Abu, I've seen it in a movie. If you tell me what's the density of water in a lake in Nevada, I've seen it in a movie. So everything that I know about life is through movies. I pretty much try to talk things beyond movies and अलग अलग सब्जेक्ट्स में कभी कभी लोग थोड़े से सप्रे अरे इसको ये कैसे मालूम उनको नहीं मालूम मैंने पिक्चर में देखा था तो आई लव मूवीज फरीदून एंड I live inside a virtual cinema. My bedroom is actually a cinema. It's 4K, Dolby Atmos, DTS:X, state-of-the-art movie collection. And I've been doing this ever since I was a kid. I used to collect movie tickets. Then I moved on to VHS, then DVDs, Laserdiscs, now 4K. So I just love movies.
All right. Okay. And what about Heyy Babyy? Now it's completing 10 years. Your first film. I still remember we saw it in famous studio. That's when the
yes.
previews used to happen at
yes.
that point of time, and we really had a great time watching the film. It was entertaining. You know, people associate you with the humor. People associate with you with the with glamour. People associate you with controversies as well. But the fact is that there's a child inside you, and we get to see that in your movies too. Heyy Babyy was about a child.
Yes, it was about more. Also, it had to do with the. I feel personally that if it's a baby girl, the father will be closely attached to it than a baby boy. Boys are more attached to their mothers. This is what I've seen and learned all my life with various different families that I've interacted with. Heyy Babyy was also loosely based on a TV friend of mine. I won't take his name because now he's a very happily married man. He was a film, a TV producer, and he had done a couple of shows with me. His wife used to tie me rakhi. What she did not know that he was having an affair. I'm not going to take names. And his marriage was almost on the rocks. And she was very worried. And I used to keep telling him, mat kar, achhi ladki yaar, kyun, why you, he said, kuch nahi, isko pata nahi chalne wala. Finally, she became pregnant. They had a child. And I met him after a couple of months and he said, yaar, I've stopped everything. I said, how come yaar, tu itam suddenly sadhu sant kaise ho gaya tu? So he said, nahi yaar, I held my daughter in my arms for the first time. Na, and I just felt that emotion ki yaar, someday some man will take my daughter for a ride. I don't want that to happen to any other woman. So I've decided to be faithful to my wife. I said, had you had a son? He says, perhaps I would have not got the same emotion for the simple reason that beta hai mera, ye bhi ladkiyon ko ghumayega, patayega, beta kiska hai? He says, beti ke saath main bahut protective ho gaya hun. He changed. And now he's a very happy man. Now he's got two more kids. But that is where I started thinking, ki yaar, Heyy Babyy is a very, very cool idea. How a person can transform with the advent of a child, especially a baby girl, in your life. You know, you as a man, you become more protective. It was loosely also inspired from a film called Nanne Farishte, Nanna Farishta. And a little bit loosely inspired by Mehmood Saab ki film, Kumara Baap. But us waqt mujhe yaad hai, puri media chad gayi thi without seeing the movie, ke three men and a baby hai. Aur main khud ka show TV pe karta tha, where I used to take Hollywood ka rip-offs and show Bollywood kaise rip-off karta. So I said, I was not that foolish to openly copy a Hollywood film which was so popular. It was loosely based on Nanna Farishta and Kumara Baap, but more or less the true story of this friend of mine.
Okay.
Now his kids are grown up. And now he's having many more affairs.
Okay, and it was the way you built the entire premise. It was shot abroad and
Shot abroad thanks to my friend and brother Sajid Nadiawala. I wanted to keep it a Delhi film.
Right.
I wanted a budget of 10 crores mein ho jayega. 10 crore mein picture acha khasa budget hai. Ek family genre wali film hai. But when Sajid Nadiawala said ki yaar, if I'm going to be making the film for you, it has to be on a larger scale. It's also my production and you're my best friend. I'm launching you as a director. So you should have the best of everything. And that's what he does in his productions also. So he took the budget up to about 20, 24, 30 crores, which was a lot of money to be spent in a film in 2006, which did not have special effects and action. And then we shifted the premise to Sydney and we made the film even more cooler.
Absolutely. Okay, the music was appreciated, the performances were appreciated, the entire camaraderie between Fardeen, Akshay and Ritesh was appreciated as well.
Which I tried doing in the office for the first 2 days. Fardeen, Ritesh and Akshay, when they met up for the first time. Ritesh and Fardeen were always with me in coffee shops and we were doing shows together and I was traveling, hosting events which they were part of. Akshay also I knew. But to bring the three of them together, Sajid Nadiawala's office, we sat and we just said, okay, let's faff around and let's read the scenes and all. That was taking a bit of time for them to become friends. They actually became friends when we reached Sydney. That time they started hanging out with each other. And that was very, mere liye wo thandak aati hai na chhati mein, haa, mera kaam ho gaya. Ab in teenon ki chemistry mein ko tension lene ki zarurat thi. Teenon ki chemistry bahut easy ho gayi thi.
Right.
So that's very important to have between co-actors, you know, chemistry.
Right. Has it occurred to you that maybe, consider that you've had the sequels to Houseful, that you'd like to make a sequel to maybe Heyy Babyy if possible?
We spoke about it. You know, Akshay and I spoke about it. Sajid Nadiawala and I also spoke about it. And it's not a bad idea. But, you know, the point is, where do we go from there? Maybe perhaps in the near future, let the baby become a little older, let her enter her teens. Now, technically, she's 10, if the film came in 2007. Even if we take a leap of faith and show her as a... I would like to make the story of a teenage daughter with three cool young fathers, you know, still in their 40s, but a teenage daughter. The generation gap between today's teenagers and a 40-year-old father, that can make very interesting viewing because teenagers think radically different from what the other generations think. When we were teenagers, we used to think differently from what the other elders used to think. Today's teenagers are far more advanced. They are far more ahead than when we were teenagers. You know, today's teenagers are also far more aware. Hum log accidentally cheeze discover kar rahe the.
Ji.
Ye log discover karke accident kar rahe
hain. No, absolutely. Okay, and now, how do you look at the entire transformation of Akshay Kumar? You've written about that in another column recently about as far as that how he has been breaking the mold, because
yes.
From what he was maybe in Heyy Babyy and what he's doing maybe say in Toilet, there's a huge transformation as far as he's concerned, and many are saying that he is the king of Bollywood right now, considering that he's had 5 back-to-back hits.
Not just 5, he had 4 back-to-back hits in 2007 also.
As well.
Namaste, you know, London. Yeah, yeah. Namaste London, Singh is King, Heyy Babyy, Heyy Babyy. Bhool Bhulaiya,
yeah.
Welcome, you know.
Right, 5 back.
Yeah,
back.
But what he's got now, Faridun, today, is he's got a massive fan following, which he always had because he was superstar Akshay Kumar, man of the masses. He's got the younger generation on his side too, which is a very strong brigade, you know. They are also your Friday, Saturday, Sunday openers. The 14, 15, 16, 18, 20-year-olds, you know. He's got this tag with them that if Akshay Kumar is doing a film today, it's going to be an entertaining film and perhaps there's going to be a message to it. Doesn't mean that he will not do entertaining films. But, you know, today the audience has a certain belief in him, like how they blindly believe in Aamir Khan films. Ke Aamir Khan ki film mein toh achhi hogi. So that is a very strong achievement for Akshay and I'm so happy for him.
In fact, I've told many people that what you told me once in an informal meeting, not on camera, that Aamir Khan ka to aisa hai ki agar ek poster bhi laga do public dekhne ke liye aayegi. That's what you told me.
But wo ek brand value bhi ban jati hai na, brand value ban jati hai ki Aamir ki picture hai to achhi hogi. To wo brand value ban jati hai.
Right.